This project is a continuation of a project we did at the Design Museum in London last year, which was called United Micro Kingdoms. And the project is about re-looking at the United Kingdom after devolution. So luckily we didn't lose Scotland, but in our scenario, Scotland goes, Wales goes, and England is left to try and decide how to make a new future. So what happens is that England is divided into four zones. Each of those zones looks at a very different political situation and it looks at a very different energy future. So we have something like a communo-nuclearists, so communism and nuclear energy. We have anarcho-Darwinists, they are anarchists and evolutionists. And then another one of them is the bioliberals, that's looking at kind of a liberal society but with sort of biotechnology technologies. And then the digitarians. One of the things we were trying to look at was looking at, could the design of products and objects tell us about a society, so working bottom up. So what we designed was four very different transport systems for these very different societies. So in this project, we wanted to carry this a little bit further. And so here we worked with the digitarians. And they're an extreme neoliberal a group of people. They're probably the closest society to what we have now. And it really is pushing the digital agenda as far as we can go forward. So all of these sort of ideas about future interfaces for the digitarians. We wanted to also challenge the way that future imagery is portrayed. One of the questions we were asking ourselves was, you know, is the collective imagination of the future, are we holding it back through seeing so many images of the past about the future? You know, how do we actually start to show the future, and what other ways aesthetically could we look at those? So that's what this study really is about, trying to open up that space so we can have many different kinds of visualizations of very different kinds of ways technology could work. So in addition to that, each of the objects is really trying to look at very different kinds of interfaces, because at the moment we're very limited to touch screens. We're looking at information on two-dimensional screens. We're doing gesture like this. Our digital information space and interactions are becoming very two-dimensional. So one of the things with these as well, we wanted to look very much at using space, a different kind of sensing. Maybe they become more spatial, maybe the body actually goes inside the devices themselves, and you read temperature, moisture, or something like that, so you sense very differently and they become very sensual interfaces again. So that's another sort of layer of this story. And then, you know, we take our sort of, you know, what these projects also try and be quite critical of some of the sort of uses of the technology. So, you know, I think we've got the shoes here. So it's almost like, you know, in the digitarian world, they want to use every possible way that you could possibly communicate. And obviously the feet, have we missed our feet? You know, as I'm standing here now, I could be communicating with my feet and you wouldn't know it. But obviously there's a missed opportunity here. And in the digitarian world, they'll be, you know, making sure that our feet can communicate and sense and take part in this space. And then the other one is a helmet, which is really looking at the idea of, now we're sort of, you know, we tweet and we send images immediately and they immediately go out into the world and we don't know what their reaction will be. So this is a little bit like a pre-text or a pre-voice, that you could try and say something in advance and it will predict what the feedback might be. It's almost like a device that helps you stay politically correct and doesn't upset too many people, or, you know, it tries to gauge the reaction you might get from using voice recognition. So another sort of a different kind of making a more of an interface. So we've tried to play with the language and we've tried to play with the use. And it was a really interesting experiment for us to, and very difficult to do actually, much harder than we thought it would be. We've called this project Not Here, Not Now, because again, we don't think it should be about the future. We think it should be alternatives. One of the key things that we think about, there should be a lot more diversity of approaches to thinking about you know, what happens next. I won't say the future because I think that can be over years, but what happens next? You know, there should be a broader range. But the position we took was very much that we wanted to look, when you go to an anthropological museum and you see an ancient kind of society and you see the tools and things that they've used, we love the idea that you look at those tools and you imagine what you think that society, how that society worked, how, you know, what the values in that society were. And so we wanted to do this in a similar way. We don't want to make any judgments. We just wanted to say, if these were the tools that exist in this society, could we imagine what kinds of values, you know, can the observer start to imagine the world? We won't show what the world is. We would just show the tools to that world. And we would like, you know, people to participate and imagine that world themselves. So we worked very much like that when we did the UMK project last year. It was very much trying to not tell people what this world will be, but try and give clues through the tools, through the material culture of the values embedded in that world.